Hello and welcome to my channel. Today in this video I am going to show you how to create this dynamic logo opener in Adobe After Effects. Before continuing, I would like to thank you for being here and supporting me. If you have not subscribed to my channel yet, I highly recommend you to click on the subscribe button. Let's get into After Effects. Create a new composition. I am calling it as main. I am choosing a 1920x1080 composition with a frame rate of 30 and a duration of 10 seconds. Create a new solid and call it as background. Search for gradient ramp effect and apply it into the background layer. Change the colors and color centers as you wish. And now create a new text layer and type in your text. Central in the text. Search for transform effect and apply it into the text layer. Set the skew value to -10. Press P to bring up the position property of the text layer and at the 2 second mark create a keyframe. Go to the 1 second mark and set the position as shown. Turn on the title action save for better positioning. Select the 2 keyframes and press F9 to ease them. Open the graph editor and change the graph as shown. Create a new solid and I am calling it as Mat1. Press P to bring up the position property and set the X value of the position to 0. Now set the track mat of the text layer to alpha inverted Mat1. Now select these 2 layers and duplicate them. Now change the track mat of the duplicated text layer to alpha Mat2. Press P to bring up the position property and go to the first keyframe and change the position as shown. So this is what we have for now. Grab the ellipse tool and with fill set to none and stroke set to solid color, create a circle like this. Hold shift to create a perfect circle. Central in the circle. Rename the shape layer to circle 1. Add trim parts to the shape layer. Open up the trim parts. Set the start and end value to 50%. And at the 1 second mark, create keyframe for both the start and end values. Go to the 2 second mark and set the start and end values so that the circle does not overlap the text layer. Select the keyframes and press F9 to ease them. Open the graph editor and change the graph as shown. Now duplicate the circle 1 and bring up the rotation property. Set the rotation value to 180 degrees. Bring up the position property of the circle 1 and create keyframe at the 2 second mark. Go to the 1 second mark and set the position value like this. Select the keyframes and press F9 to ease them. Open the graph editor and change the graph as shown. And do this for the circle 2. So bring up the position property of the circle 2 and create keyframe for position at the 2 second mark. Go to the 1 second mark and set the position value like this. Now select the keyframes and press F9 to ease them and open the graph editor and change the graph as shown. Now select the text tool and type in your text. Reduce the font size and position it like this. So that's good. At the 2 second 20 frame mark, create a keyframe for position and at the 1 second 10 frame mark, set the position value of the text layer like this. Select the keyframes and press F9 to ease them. Open the graph editor and change the graph as shown. Now create another text layer. Type in your text, position it as shown, and create keyframe at 2 second 20 frame mark. Go to the 1 second 10 frame mark and change the position as shown. Now apply the transform effect to both these subtext layers and set the skew value to -10 for both these two text layers. I forgot to easy ease the keyframes. Select the keyframes and press F9 to easy ease them. Open the graph editor and change the graph as shown. Adjust the keyframes according to your wish. Now grab the pen tool and create a stroke like this. Rename the shape layer to stroke and add trim paths to it. Open up the trim paths. And at around 1 second 25 frame mark, create keyframe for start value. Before that, set the end value to 0% and go forward in time for 15 or 20 frames. And set the start value to 100. Select the keyframes and press F9 to easy ease them and open the graph editor and change the graph as shown. Now go forward in time for about 5 frames. And create keyframe for end value. Set the end value to 100% and go backward in time for about 15 or 20 frames. And set the end value to 0. Now select these two keyframes and press F9 to easy ease them. And open the graph editor and change the graph as shown. Add repeater to the stroke layer. Open up the repeater one and set the copies to 20. Open up the transform properties in the repeater one and set the position value to 0 and set the rotation value to 18 degrees. Now duplicate any one of the circle layers, move it above all the layers and rename it to circle mat. Delete the keyframes for the position property and also delete the trim paths for the circle mat layer. Now set the stroke to none and fill to solid color for the circle mat layer. Now change the track mat of the stroke layer to alpha inverted circle mat. That's it, we have created a dynamic logo opener in Adobe After Effects. Hope you enjoyed this video. Check out my other videos. I have playlists for tutorials on Adobe After Effects Premiere Pro, Photoshop and Lightroom. Don't forget to subscribe my channel. And also click on the bell icon so that you get notified as soon as I post new videos. Like, comment and share. And thanks for being here and supporting me. Thanks for watching. This is Raudran signing off.